Mrs. Roberts, the chauffeur is waiting to drive you to the airport.
Thanks, Aaron.
Darling, it's not too late to change your mind and stay.
Can we...
Look how it looked when he came in here. The only reason he even did that was to make sure I didn't run off with CJ.
Honey, maybe that's his way of... asking you to stay and try and work things out.
I really wish I could believe that. I do, but somehow I think that's just one really big fantasy.
Okay, here he is. CJ wants to give his mommy one more goodbye kiss.
Oh, honey. Oh, thank you. Honey, you take care. I'm going to miss you. But you know what? Honey, I'm going to be back real soon, okay?
Tell you what, let me take CJ. Come on, darling. We're going to go and see what Kevin and Joey are doing. You know, I bet they're ready for lunch. Would you like a little lunch? Come on, let's go see what they're having for lunch, okay?
See you later, sport.
You have a safe trip.
Thank you.
I love you.
I love you. Bye, Andy.
Lunch.
You know, CJ decided he doesn't like carrots anymore, and if you don't make him eat them, he'll probably never grow out of it.
Okay.
And you read him a bedtime story every night, right?
I always do.
Well, you know, as soon as... He's going to pretend he's asleep, and as soon as you leave the room, he's going to start crying for a glass of water. You know that, right?
Yeah, I know the routine. Don't worry, I'm going to take real good care of our boy.
And what about you? I mean, Asa, I know how he likes to keep you up all night talking...
I'll get plenty of sleep. You got your passport?
Yeah, it's in my purse.
Good.
Well, I guess I better be going. I don't want to keep everybody waiting.
Tina?
Yes?
Maybe if you called once in a while, CJ wouldn't miss his mama too much.
Yeah. Well, I'll miss you.
I really do care what happens to you.
You also have a lot of reasons to hate me.
I do not hate you. You were good and you were kind, and I'm sorry, but it got buried somewhere along the way. Somehow you lost it for a while. But I knew you could never leave Landy with Brenda's baby.
I almost did.
No, but you didn't. You couldn't. You know, sometimes I think I know you better than you know yourself.
It's hard to have faith in yourself when no one else does.
That's my fault. I lost my way for a while, too. I did some things I'm not very proud of, and I hurt some people sometimes without realizing it. And sometimes deliberately, like when I hurt you. But if you could learn to trust me again, I promise it won't happen again. And if you can learn to trust yourself again, I'll help you find your way back.
Do you really think there is a way back for me?
Oh, I think so. I think you made the first step when you told Brenda the truth.
You should have seen the pain on her face. Max, if you find you can't forgive me, I'll understand. And no matter what happens, no matter what the police do to me or what people say about me, would you please promise me that you'll never take Al out of my life?
Gabrielle.
Please. If I'm not part of his life, I don't know how I'm going to survive this. Just the same way I don't know how Brenda's going to survive without us.
We will find Michael and Stephen. And as for Al, he will always be part of your life. So why don't you get some rest? I'll come back later, okay?
Max?
Hmm?
Would you give Al a kiss from me?
You bet.
Visitors?
Are you?
Hello, Max. Is John here?
No, why should John be here?
We called and asked him to meet us.
Max, who is it?
It's nothing. You just get some sleep. Listen, she needs her rest. Can you guys talk to her later?
No, we can't. Will you step aside?
Herb, I hate when you talk official to me.
Move aside, Max.
Is this contagious? I hope you don't mind if I stay until John gets here, Captain.
Not at all.
Oh, God.
What is that?
It's a warrant for your arrest on the charges of endangering the welfare of a minor. Kidnapping.